the oldest park in baseball, MLB The Show comes your way from Fenway Park in Boston. We celebrate Jackie Robinson Day with a great matchup between the Tampa Bay Rays and the Boston Red Sox. It's baseball, it's The Show, and it comes your way next. Chris Sale will be on the bump for game two of the series. Harold, what do you got?
Well, Matt, how I'd categorize this guy, I'd say he's a very reliable major league pitcher. Last year, ERA under 3.5, but he's consistent. What you see is what you get. He gives you innings, and he takes the ball for you.
Now in the box, Steven Souza. He will lead this
leading
one off
the
today.
For Tampa Bay, right fielder, Steven Souza.
And we are underway from Fenway as the first pitch is taken for ball one. Well, these Red Sox entering play here this afternoon, HR. They've had it going the last 10 games. They're 7-3 over that stretch, including a win last time out.
Matt, it's always nice to play at home, and to win the first game of a series makes it even extra special. They just got to go out and play real well and maybe keep the streak going.
Blue skies forecasted this afternoon, 58 degrees here at first pitch. 2-0 count, here it comes. Look out, all over the place now, 3-0.
Wow, fastball up and in. I'm not sure it was intended to be that far up and that far in, but message sent, beware.
Set to deliver on 3-0. Takes a fastball on the inside corner.
Finally got one over. Nothing worse than starting the game with a four-pitch walk.
Three balls and a strike. Here's the pitch. Hit hard on the ground towards second.
Pedroia dives. What a stop.
He is out.
Great play to his left into the hole on that one. And something to notice is how he had time to get back to his feet for the throw. He knew he had to hurry, but he didn't have to rush.
Into the box now. Brad Miller, as the first pitch to him is off the plate for a ball, 1-0. He's ready for his first at bat of this early season contest. He's ready. Here's the 1-0. And here's a fastball inside as the count moves to 2-0 now. Lifetime against Chris Sale, 0-for-5. Two and oh pitch on the way, and he gets the call that time for strike number one. Time for a look at our umpires in this one. Behind the plate is Earl Hendricks.
Yeah, Matt, Hendricks is another one of those well-respected umpires. Some say he favors one side of the plate from time to time, but most of the time it's not very noticeable.
Into the windup, here's the 2-1 pitch. Looks at a fastball inside, so he's in the driver's seat. 3-1. Just underway here at Fenway Park. And he lays off here, ball four, and he'll become the game's first base runner here with one away.
Batting third, left fielder, Corey
stepping Dickerson. In, Corey Dickerson. The early season batting line well above 300 coming into this one, so he'll look to keep that kind of success going. And he'll step off and fire to the bag. And he has to dive, but he's back in easily. First offering on its way. A changeup that just catches the bottom of the zone for a strike.
Hey, not a bad take there on that first pitch. Not a real good idea to go up there looking for a changeup to hit. Sometimes you just have to tip your cap.
The 0-1 pitch, and there's ball one. Ready with the 1-1 pitch. Saws him off here as this ball's popped into the air. And this is going to work out for him. It's an infield single to make it first and second now.
Infield single, as innocent as it may sound, that might be a rally starter right there.
So stepping in, Evan Longoria. And it's been a slow start to the year, as you see there, just barely over the 200 mark here in April. He's ready. Here's the first offering. Pitch in the dirt, and that scoots right on by. So now two men in scoring position.
Well, you live by the sword, you die by it too. He went with an off-speed pitch down in the zone, and that's the risk you take there. The catcher can't come up with it, and two runners advance. Now they're both into scoring position.
Second and third here, one man out. Swung on and missed on a pitch at the thumbs, a ball and a strike.
Well, Matt, this is a situation in last night's game. They didn't do a very good job driving in runs. Now, in this game, you capitalize on it. You grow from your mistakes and be able to come back and deliver in this one here.
A fastball that just misses inside. Tried to crush that ball and now perhaps needs to shorten up with two strikes.
A lot of times you see guys in the middle of the order get worked away, but not right here. They're keeping it inside on him.
He's set. Here's the 2-2. And there's a pitch that just misses the inside corner. Wilson Ramos is on deck. And a good eye there from Longoria as he's aboard. It's ball four. And the run will score as the Rays cash in on an early 1-0 lead.
Batting fifth, catcher Wilson Ramos.
Here's the catcher Wilson Ramos. He went hitless last night in a game where his guys could push across only one score. First pitch on its way. A high fastball is in there.
Matt, this is how you want to start a game. First inning, you already jump on them early. You get one run in, and now you have two other runners on base. You come up with a big hit here, you can really make a big dent right here in this game in the first inning.
Here's the 0-1. Squared that one up just a little late.
Matt, he's thrown two pitches right down the middle and got away with them. I don't think he should go back there again, but he's got to locate a little bit better if he wants to put him away. This guy's too good a hitter.
Working for the punch out and the offering. Got him swinging. Chased it well out of the zone, and there are two gone. Time now for a look at the Rays starting nine. How do they get back into the win column here, Harold?
Matt, have you seen this guy throw? Ooh, he is electric. What do you got to do against him? I think you got to attack him early. He's just too overpowering. His stuff is electric. He's got one of those great power arms that we'll talk about for years to come. You got to take it to him before he takes it to you.
First pitch coming. Here it is. Colby Rasmus is at the plate as he takes a cold strike one.
Well, Matt, the big thing I'm looking at is how many pitches he's already thrown here in the first inning. He's got a high pitch count. So if he continues like this, we're definitely going to see a bullpen game.
Skied in the air to straightaway left. Benintendi in pursuit. And that's the third out. Will settle for just the one. We'll move on to the bottom half of inning number one. The Rays are out in front, 1-0. Alex Cobb gets the ball for the Rays in this one. What's your take on him, H?
Well, Matt, if you look at the rotation, this is the guy everybody questions. How is he still in? ERA over 5 last season. But what I see is a guy that they trust. He's going to take the ball. He's going to go. I'll be out there and battle. And let's just see if maybe he can turn this trend around of inconsistency.
Into the box now is Dustin Pedroia as he'll lead off the home half of inning number one.
Dustin Pedroia.
And this one's chopped foul right at home plate. And Harold, the Rays, as they begin play here this afternoon, they dropped another one last time out, and in fact they've won just twice in their last eight tries.
Yeah, Matt, it's been a little bit of a struggle. 1-3 on the road trip. You never want to be in that position, but you try to pick up as many wins as you possibly can. That's why this game today is important.
A curveball hit right back at him, and he'll flip on to first to record the out. Now a chance here from Fenway to take a look at John Farrell's starting lineup card. HR, how do they send their fan base home happy here today?
Well, Matt, they find themselves already down one. The big thing here, realize you got a lot of game left. Just score one run. Try to get right back in the game, even it up, and play the whole nine innings. You can't just play part of the game, play the whole game.
Here's Xander Bogaerts now. Lifetime history with Alex Cobb, 2-for-3. Here's a curveball that runs outside. It's ball one.
That curveball is a pitch you have to get on top of, or else it'll take off just like that one did.
Now a swing and a ball popped high in the air over toward foul ground. And he'll lunge out of the crouch to make the play for out number two.
That's exactly what they wanted out of that pitch up in the zone. They took him up the ladder and he couldn't get up to it. So that was an easy pop out. Well executed pitch there.
Digging in, Mookie Betts. First cuts for him here with the bases open and two away. First pitch of the at bat. He takes a knee-high fastball. Bases are empty here with two men out. Set up away with the changeup, but it's 1-1. Here's the 1-1 delivery. Takes a high fastball for a strike.
Oh, he reached back and towns him right there. I like that. Early in the count. Here it is, big fella. I know you're a good hitter, but I'm coming right after you.
Cobb's ready, looking to put him away here on a ball and two strikes. And strike three called as he says, you got to be kidding me, with the side retired. So nothing happening this time around. On to the second inning now from Fenway Park. It's the Rays 1 and the Red Sox nothing. So striding forward now, Tim Beckham, and he'll step in to start things out against Chris Sale. Here's the first pitch to him. Tough one to lay off, called a strike. Into the windup, here comes the 0-1. And he popped him up, drifting back behind first. Holt will stay with it as he backs up and puts it away, one gone.
All right, time for a majestic defensive alignment for the Red Sox. Ricky Weeks. And I'm looking out there at second base, Dustin Pedroia. You talk about a gold glove, gritty player. That fits him perfect. He's going to catch everything at second. He's gold glove worthy. And then gritty, don't hit him, he'll knock you back.
So coming to the plate, Ricky Weeks. And pitchers beware, because he's been off the charts hot to start the season. Into the windup and the pitch. Takes a look at one catching the outside corner.
Well, they got to him in the first inning, which is huge, but he looks a lot more settled into this ball game right now. He's not the kind of pitcher you want to let get into a groove out there.
And low, it's a ball and a strike. One out, nobody on. Tries to change up on him there, but it's a ball, 2-1. Into the windup. Here's the 2-1 pitch. On a good pitch there. Had him stretching to get out there. And it's 2-2 now. Into the windup. Here comes the 2-2 pitch. Liner toward right center. But this will not get out there deep enough as it's run down by the right fielder in the alley for the second out.
He got that one pretty good. It just didn't have the right launch angle to carry over the outfielder's head. Small difference where the ball hit the bat could have made all the difference.
Standing in, Michael King. He'll work on keeping this top of the second alive. First delivery to him on the way. Left field and deep. Benintendi going back on it. He tracks it down, and that will end the inning. Down in order go the Rays. And after an inning and a half, it's 1-0. Here's Hanley Ramirez. He went deep in the contest last night.
Designated hitter, Hanley Ramirez.
Curveball is nowhere close, and it's 1-0. Here's the 1-0 now to Ramirez. And the changeup is way low that time.
Wow, not a great spot to be in right now. 2-0 to a great hitter like this. This is when you really have to pay attention as a pitcher. And if you have good off-speed stuff, this might be the time to start mixing in your off-speed stuff.
And he'll lay the fastball in here to get the count back to 2-1. Speed pitch, good for strike two.
Well, that changeup right there sets up a lot of things. Now the count's 2-2. He can come back in with a fastball, and it's going to look like it's moving a little bit better. Or he can go back to that changeup.
Swung on and missed. He didn't even come close to contact on a ball way out of the zone. One out.
Well, let's take a look at the Rays defense. Brought to you by Majestic. And yes, they are moving all over the field. They love to shift heavily into the analytics, and they really move players around playing the percentages. You'll see that a lot in this game today.
Here's Jackie Bradley now. Lifetime history with Alex Cobb. A number of meetings, he's 1-for-7. Here comes the first pitch. And a fastball there is inside as that one backed him up a bit.
What makes hitting so difficult is covering both sides of the plate. And that hard pitch right there that was inside makes it awfully tough now to cover both the inside and the outside part of the plate.
Hit in the air to left. Dickerson's there. And that's the second out of the inning.
Batting six. First baseman.
So digging in now, Brock Holt will try to make something happen with two gone in the bottom of the second. First pitch coming, here it is. Down on the shins and missed with it, ball one. Two out, nobody on. Favorable call in there for a strike. From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. Fooled him a bit as this is hit high in the air towards right center and shallow. Souza shading to his right, and the inning is over. Red Sox go down 1-2-3. They still trail 1-0. There they are, the teammates, Ted Williams, Johnny Pesky, Bobby Doerr, and Dom DiMaggio, four great Red Sox that played right here as teammates, of course, at Fenway.
Leading off for Tampa Bay.
Digging in for his second at-bat, Steven Souza. He'll step in to lead it off in the top of the third. Third inning starts with a slider that's looked at here for ball one. And maybe a little frustrated on the mound here as the fastball misses for ball two now. Sale ready with the 2-0. Swing and a miss way behind the big fastball.
Boy, Matt, we're watching him have great success on that exploding fastball at the top of the zone. And I'm telling you right now, you can't catch up to that. It looks great to you coming in, but you have to get your bat in the position to get on top of it. And it's just too hard to do all those things and think you're going to square it up. Boy, that's an ugly swing right there. And they haven't been getting on base. They're not doing much of anything right now. And I'll tell you what, they got to figure out something to make an adjustment or this game could get ugly quick.
Line fouled off to the right over the Red Sox dugout. A full count, three balls and two strikes. And he lays off there, ball four. So the leadoff man is on here to begin inning number three.
That leadoff walk is a great way to start this inning when you're looking to pad the lead. Could be the beginning of good things here in this half inning.
Ready for another chance? Brad Miller. No official at bat for him, but he has scored a run in this one. First offering on its way. A swing and a miss on a ball that jammed him.
He couldn't quite catch up to that one. He needs to get his foot down and see the fastball out of his hand.
Comes set with the 0-1. And I believe they'll say he broke the plane, as yes, he did. It's ruled a strike. Nobody out, runner on first. Swing and a miss on the slider, and that's out number one.
Boy, he's having a hard time just putting the ball in play right now. He took the hat trick with three strikeouts yesterday, and here's another one today. Looks to me like he just needs to simplify his approach and focus on making some contact.
In now, Corey Dickerson. As the first pitch misses to him, it's ball one. Here comes the 1-0. There's a swing, and he sends a ball high in the air into left field. Benintendi ranging back. And it's off the Green Monster. Throw won't get him.
Now batting, third baseman Evan Longoria.
In is the third baseman Evan Longoria as he lifts it in the air to right field. Betts has a read on it, makes the catch, but the runner from third breaks for home. And it's a sack fly and an RBI. It's now a 2-0 game.
Hey, great job there by this power hitter, known for driving the ball out of the ballpark. Does the job right there with the sack fly and brings the run home.
Stepping in and ready for another shot, Wilson Ramos, 0-for-1 here in the early going. Here's the first pitch to him. And a fastball just below the knees, ball one. The 1-0 delivery. And he takes a pitch right down the middle.
Well, I like that, taking that strike right there. Look, he's already walked a couple guys early. He's not throwing the ball consistently in the zone. You have to be patient and make him work.
A runner on first with two away. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike.
Two balls, one strike.
He's set, and the 2-1 pitch. Chops it foul at home plate as the count moves to 2-2 now.
He's clearly looking to hit off the fastball and adjust. That's a pretty good swing after seeing two fastballs now in a row.
And this one's in the dirt. Neither guy willing to give in, and the at-bat will continue. Once again, a 3-2. And another foul ball. The next 3-2. Oh, and a look what I found out there on the mound. And he'll flip it onto first, and with it, that ends the inning. So a run on one hit, no errors, and a man left. We'll head now to the home half of inning number three. Tampa Bay leads this one 2-0. Here's the Panda now, Pablo Sandoval. 7, 8, and 9 to start the home third.
Not much going on offensively so far for these guys. 6 up, 6 down. We'll see if the bottom part of the lineup can get something going.
Well, the home crowd seems a little restless, so I'm sure they'd appreciate it. Into the windup and the pitch. Takes a look down at the knees for a strike.
0-1.
Into the windup. Here comes the 0-1. Looking at a tough pitch, called a strike.
He's really throwing the ball well in this game. And the thing to me that stands out is that two-seamer. He's got great movement, and he's keeping hitters off balance with it.
Here comes the 0-2 pitch. Not a bad pitch there with two strikes, but it misses 1-2. Here he comes on a ball and two strikes. Tries to go the other way as this is in the air to left field. Dickerson comes in a few steps as he hauls it in for the first out. Still far too early for any semblance of a race to take shape, but we'll give you a look anyways at our standings here in April. Digging in, the switch hitter, Sandy Leon. He'll get to take his first cuts here. And that one stayed too low, apparently. Red Sox still looking for their first hit here. Grounded up the first baseline. King is there, and he'll take it to the bag himself for the out. The left-handed hitting Andrew Benintendi stands in. He comes into this one having sputtered out of the gate this season. The average is under the 200 mark at this point. First pitch of the at-bat on its way. And he takes ball one.
Boy, they've been just getting shut down right here. Been a while since they've even had a runner on. So I think it's time to start looking for ways to make some things happen. Drop a bunt, get up on the plate, something.
Cobb into the windup. Here's the 1-0. And oh, looked like ball two below the knees, but it's ruled a strike, and that evens the count at 1-1. And now a pitch on the way. And he misses 2-1.
Sometimes it can be difficult for a pitcher. You're facing a guy that's not known to be a big stick in the lineup. Sometimes the toughest thing is to be aggressive and throw strikes.
Gets the sign. Here comes the 2-1. There's the cold strike he was looking for. 2-2 now. Now here it comes. Look out. Don't want to hit him there. It's full 3-2.
Well, he really needs to make this guy swing the bat right here. He's not the type of hitter you want to dance around with.
Hit pretty well out to deep left field. Dickerson racing back. He makes the play. A great catch on the run to retire the side. When we return, we'll see Colby Rasmus start things out. It's the Rays 2 and the Red Sox nothing. Digging in to try it again, Colby Rasmus. He'll try to get it going here to begin the fourth.
Colby Rasmus.
First offering on its way. A fastball down near the shoe tops. Into his windup, here comes the 1-0. And he jumps at a changeup, a swing and a miss.
Now that's a good changeup right there. You know the guy's sitting fastball, you get him out in front. Now that changeup's in his head the rest of the at-bat.
From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. In there at the letters, 1-2 now. And he wasn't going to hit that one with an or. The strikeout, and there's one gone. Another strikeout for him on the mound, and boy, is it fun to watch him go about his business.
No doubt, Matty. He's one of my favorites, mostly because of his stuff. You know, he can absolutely dominate on any given day because of what he offers up there. It's just nasty. There aren't many hitters that like to see this guy on the mound.
Standing in now, Tim Beckham. So far, 0-for-1 with a flyout. The windup and the 0-1. There's a knee-high pitch that catches the zone. The windup and the 0-2 pitch. Down and away, it's a ball and two strikes. Here comes the 1-2 from Sale. Look out, that one almost got away from him. 2-2 now.
He went with the off-speed there once he got him to 0-2, but now that they both missed, I think we'll see more of a challenge pitch here. You don't have to give in, but you can't be too cute either.
He pops up the changeup, heading out towards shallow right. And this will be taken by Pedroia for out number two.
Now batting, designated hitter, Ricky Weeks.
Striding in once again, Ricky Weeks comes into this at bat 0-for-1 in the ballgame. Into the windup and the pitch. And here's a fastball called for strike one. Into the windup, here comes the 0-1. Ball one. One and one, here it comes. And he gets a piece of it here, but it's chopped foul. Set to deal on a ball and two strikes. Swing and a miss. Blew the fastball right by him, and the inning is over. Rays go in order, 1-2-3, as they're unable to add to their 2-0 lead. Back with Harold Reynolds and Dan Plesac, Matt Vasgersian with you as Dustin Pedroia settles in to get the inning underway. Ready to deliver. Here's the first pitch. And this one's nowhere close as that bounces to the plate for ball one. Pitch on the way. That's wide, 2-0. The 2-0 on the way. 3-0 now.
Well, they haven't had a lot of offense in this game. Right now, though, you got three balls here. Maybe this will be the leadoff walk that gets things going for them.
No walks yet. Here's the delivery. And oh, they won't let him walk that easily, as that somehow ruled a strike. 3-1 now. And the pitch. And that misses for ball four. It's a leadoff walk that starts the bottom of the fourth.
Yeah, well, when a guy's swinging the bat as well as he's been, this is a smart move. No reason to tempt fate out there.
Here's Xander Bogaerts now. 0 for 1 for him here in this one. Here's the first pitch to him. Right over the middle, knee high. Here's the 0-1. Check swing as he pops this one onto the right side. King battles the sun a bit, but has it for out number one.
Now batting, right fielder, Mookie.
Here's Mookie Betts. He's 0 for 1 thus far. From the stretch, here's the pitch. Swing, line drive. That's going to be trouble. And this will find the wall out near the visitor's bullpen. And they're on the board as now it's a 2-run ball game.
That is what every manager is looking for out of the middle of his lineup. When you get your 3, 4, and 5 hitters producing this early in the season, it can be contagious, and everyone in the lineup starts to contribute.
Here's Hanley Ramirez as he will look at a first pitch fastball for ball one. He was a strikeout victim in his first try. Here comes the 1-0. Adam fooled as this is popped up back behind short. And this will be taken in here by Beckham for the second out. So striding in, Jackie Bradley Jr. as he'll look to bring home that tying run from second with a base hit into the outfield. Cobb comes set. First pitch on its way. And a curveball that time that broke too low.
Backdoor breaking ball just missed right there. It's such an effective pitch if you can hit the corner with it, but no dice this time.
Sneaks a fastball by him at the letters. It's 1-1.
I think it's safe to say he wasn't ready for the fastball.
Yeah, and they set him up with that curveball on the pitch before, and that one, they just blew right by him.
And they could go either way now, I suppose.
And now a fastball, but he's able to hold off on it, and it's 2-1 now. In the dirt, and now let's see. And he's going to make it up to third here as he advances on the wild pitch.
That can be a tough read as a runner on second to see if the ball has gotten away enough to move to third. You have to be sure you can make it. He was there, and now he's only 90 feet away.
One run, just one hit, and no errors for the Red Sox to this point. Little dribbler up the first baseline, but that one rolls foul.
And awfully close there on 3-2, but take your base, says Earl Hendricks. It's ball four.
And things are not looking good here in the fourth inning. That's the second walk of the frame. Good time for the catcher to go out to the mound and have a chat with this guy to give him a little breather.
Here's Brock Holt now, as he's got a chance to tie this ball game up with that equalizing run just 90 feet away at third. First offering on its way. And he gets ahead here with the fastball, strike one.
After the walk and with runners on the bags, he couldn't afford to fall behind here. Nice job of jumping ahead with strike one.
Off speed pitch in the dirt as he takes it for a ball.
Hey, two walks in this inning already, so he can't expect to stay out there much longer if he puts somebody else on. We'll see if he can find it.
Here it comes on 1-1. Hit out toward second. Gloved by Miller. Throw in time, and the side is retired. Sights and sounds of a day at the ballpark. Oh, my goodness. More of the show, Saturday Baseball, after this. Striding in, Michael King comes into this at bat 0-for-1 in the ball game. First delivery to him on the way. Ball one. And wow, a very high strike, but a strike nonetheless, and it's 1-1. Here it comes. 2-1.
You know what, Matt? He's been getting most of the pitches. I know he's complaining a little bit on this one, but he's been getting most of the pitches today. He should be feeling pretty good about himself.
Into the windup. Here's the 2-1 pitch. There's the cold strike he was looking for. 2-2 now. A swing and a miss on a ball way out of the zone, and there's one away.
Wow, that's the case right there where a pitcher knows this guy's up there. Up he's in swing mode. That pitch wasn't even close to the strike zone, and he still swung at it.
Stepping in now, Steven Souza, as he looks at a fastball that misses off the plate for ball one. 0-for-2 on the afternoon so far. And he misses again, 2-0. Two runs on two hits, and no errors for Tampa Bay so far. In there, 2-1.
I like that pitch right there. You know he's keyholing you 2-0, and you put one right on the corner, he's not going to swing at it, and now all of a sudden you're back in the count again.
Now the pitch. 3-1. Ready on 3-1. Here's the pitch. Takes a fastball on the inside corner. And he gives this one a pretty good ride down the left field line. And this had home run distance, but it just does hook foul. The 3-2 one more time. A swing and a miss for out number two, and a ball he had no chance of making contact with.
Two up, two down on strikes in this inning. He looks really sharp out there, guys.
Brad Miller.
Digging in once again, Brad Miller. First two men in the inning have both gone down via the punch out, so we'll see if he can fare any better. Oh,
And a check swing here, but he clearly went around on a pitch that would have been a strike anyway. It's nothing and one. Now the pitch. Bouncer down the line. That winds up foul for the second strike.
He's done a nice job of getting those two quick outs before the two hitters come to the plate right now, because he knows what's sitting down there down the order. So you stay aggressive against those little guys, try to get them out the way.
Trying to strike out the side. Here it is. That's it to short. Does he have another 1-2-3 inning? He does. Eight in a row he's set down, and the side is retired. Down in order go the Rays. They lead it 2-1. Coming to the plate now, Pablo Sandoval. 0-for-1 for him here in this one.
Pablo Sandoval.
Into the windup and the pitch. And that one stayed too low, apparently. The windup and the 1-0 pitch. Fastball just a bit low here. He's behind 2-0 now. Pitch on the way. And there's the first strike, 2-1.
Love the pitch call there, 2-0. You know the guy's geared up for a fastball, and you drop a changeup in the zone, that's going to be a tough pitch to handle.
Hitters count now. Here's the 2-1. And this will be fouled away.
Oh, he's looking pretty good right now. Look, that was a nice swing following the changeup. He just couldn't put it in play.
Pops this one up. Ramos waits on it. One down.
Now batting. Catcher. Sandy.
Now
Leon.
At the plate, Sandy Leon. He's 0-for-1 thus far. First pitch coming. Here it is. And this is taken outside for ball one. Fifth inning. 2-1 our score. Swing and a miss, 1-1.
1-1.
From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. Out in front as he rolls over it to second. Miller's got it. Throw on to first, two gone.
Now batting, left fielder. Andrew Benintendi.
The left-handed hitting Andrew Benintendi stands in. Flied out in his first at-bat, so make him 0-for-1 so far. Cold strike at the letters, 0-1.
Matt, I'm a little surprised he's throwing as well as he is. He's pitching less than 40% first pitch strikes, and it's either very deceptive or his stuff is electric to the hitters. Usually that doesn't happen when you're behind that much to have this kind of success.
Good changeup that time, but he wouldn't bite on it. Bases are empty here with two men out. Fought off at the plate as it's chopped foul. Ready to deliver the 1-2. Drilled right back up the middle. Beckham ranges to his left. Throw in the dirt, but a good scoop at first. Saves an error as the side is retired. Down in order go the Red Sox. They still trail it here 2-1. Ready for another shot now. Corey Dickerson, a couple of singles to his credit thus far.
Corey Dickerson.
And now Boston's bullpen springs into action. A left-hander and a right-hander begin to throw. high and tight here to begin the inning. It's ball one.
Well, that ball's high as a strike in the zone can go, but umpires don't like to reward pitchers on that one. They want to make you get the ball down, so he called it a ball. Throw it down, you'll get the strike.
Here comes the 1-0. And this is just off the outside corner, ball two. Swing and a miss on the heater, and it's 2-1. Gets the sign. Here comes the 2-1. Now a ball hit in the air, but in play perhaps down the line. And he will run this one down, moving to his right, and that's the first out of the inning. In is the third baseman, Evan Longoria. He hit a sack fly earlier. Into the windup and the pitch. A fastball here as he'll take a look at ball one. 1-0.
He's been doing a nice job out there on the mound, but the deeper you get into the game, the more the hitters have seen you. This is the part of the lineup that he has to be really careful with.
The windup and the 1-0 pitch. And that one stayed up a little high. Low scoring game thus far, 2-1 here in the sixth. And this is fouled at the plate. Gets the sign. Here comes the 2-1. Ripped on the ground to first. And he'll step on first himself for the out.
Now batting, catcher Wilson Ramos.
Here's the catcher, Wilson Ramos. He comes in 0 for 2 thus far. First pitch on its way. Sends that one out of play for strike one. Into the windup, here comes the 0-1. And no swing, apparently, ball one.
Well, you're in trouble at the plate if you fall behind this guy, 0-2, so that was a good job to hold up right there.
1-1, here it comes. Looking at a fastball for a strike on the corner. Two out, nobody on. And look out, he has to back away there and then give a little glare out to the mound. It's ball two.
Pretty sure there wasn't any ill will behind that pitch considering he has two strikes on. Just got away from him from what I could tell.
And he struck him out, his seventh of the ball game, and that ends the inning. Rays go in order, 1-2-3. They still lead it 2-1. Here's the second baseman now, Dustin Pedroia. He'll start things out in their half of the sixth as they look to shake things up here for a lineup that, quite frankly, has been non-existent to date.
No doubt about that, Matt. They've been completely overmatched to this point. One hit through five innings. I mean, what else can you say about the pitching they faced other than it's been fantastic? We'll see if that continues as we approach the later inning.
A couple of righties starting to loosen now in the bullpen. Here's a first pitch chop foul right at home plate, and that's the first strike. The windup and the 0-1. And the changeup is way low that time. Well, he's having a good amount of success here, Dan, even though he hasn't really gotten a ton of swings and misses.
Yeah, but for him, Matt, he's more of a pitch to contact kind of guy, and obviously it's working so far, and the way he pitches, it really keeps his pitch count down.
Sent on the ground out to second. Miller is there. Throw to first is in time for the first down.
Now batting, shortstop, Xander Bogaerts.
Ready for another chance? Xander Bogaerts. It's been an 0 for 2 effort for him to this point. Chop fouled over towards the coaching box. Bases are empty, one man out. And here's a foul ball just off to the right as they get ahead of him here, nothing and two. The windup and the 0-2 pitch. Little dribbler back at him. On to first, and there were two down.
Now batting, right fielder, Mookie.
Stepping in and ready for another shot, Mookie Betts. 1-for-2 with a double on the ledger so far. Lays off 1-0.
He's obviously been very impressive on the mound in this one, and I think the big reason why is his ability to stay out of the middle of the zone. That's kind of obvious, but it's clear to me that even when he misses his spots, he's not missing over the plate.
2-0 now.
Those first two pitches were pretty good pitches. I like where he was going, but now he's falling behind 2-0. He may have to lay one in there and challenge him a little bit.
Now here's the pitch. Called a strike on the inside part of the plate, 2-1. That's it to short. Does he have another 1-2-3 inning? He does. Seven in a row he's set down now as the side is retired. Red Sox go down 1-2-3. Our score remains 2-1. Welcome back to Fenway Park here in the great city of Boston. We're in the seventh with the Rays out in front, and let's get you caught up with our game summary for the first six innings. Here's the center fielder now, Colby Rasmus. He'll start the seventh, and Dan, as a former pitcher yourself, you must be enjoying this. Lots of good pitching and defense today.
Oh, that's one of the keys. We're seeing a lot of strikes. We're seeing a lot of swings. We're seeing some great plays on defense. This has been a snappy one up to this point.
Yeah, we see a lefty and a right-hander start to loosen up in the bullpen. Ready to deliver. Here's the first pitch. And he'll try to hold back the swing, but he'll do so unsuccessfully as that's ruled a strike. Here's the pitch. Fouled back.
Well, clearly that changed up the pitch before it didn't fool him, because that fastball right there, he's right on it. He just couldn't put it in play.
Way outside. 1-2.
I have no issue wasting a pitch on 0-2 to try to get a guy to go fishing, but it has to be somewhat tempting. You're not going to get anyone to swing at a bat at that pitch.
Looking to punch him out again. The pitch.
Got him.
And that's 8 strikeouts now for him in the ballgame.
Nice job there taking care of the leadoff hitter via the strikeout. I'll tell you, in a one-run game, especially this late, getting that first guy in the inning is so important. It changes the whole complexion of the inning, so that was a big out.
Here comes Sox manager John Farrell on his way out to the mound. And he's going to make a change, as that'll be all for his starter, Chris Sale. So he'll wind up going 6 1/3, and he's kept his club in it to this point, though he cannot win the ball game. Joe Kelly is into the ball game now as he'll make his 5th appearance of the season here.
Joe Kelly.
Digging in to try it again, Tim Beckham. No hits in 2 trips to the plate for him in the ballgame. In there for strike 1, 0-1.
Well, these hitters can expect to see a heavy dose of that big fastball from this reliever. It's a major part of his arsenal.
We're in the 7th inning now of a pitcher's duel. 2-1 our score. That's over, but low. It's a ball and a strike. Here's the 1-1 pitch. Took a wave at one around the shins with no luck.
Really deceptive changeup there. Very well executed. It looks like it just sort of dies when it gets close to the plate.
A ball and 2 strikes. Here's the pitch. Now this pitch sails up and in, and that leaves him muttering to himself. It's ball 2.
Not sure if that was a purpose pitch or not, but I like it. As a pitcher, sometimes you've got to be willing to back the guy off the play fight, running something hard inside. You can't just let guys be comfortable standing in the batter's box against you.
And a swing and a miss here, so it's a quick two outs to start the seventh.
Yeah, as they say, there's a hole in his swing in that location, so a good job there of exploiting that. That can be real hard for some guys to overcome when teams start figuring out what locations you just can't handle.
Into the box, Ricky Weeks. As he'll look at a breaking ball that misses for ball one. He's 0 for 2 in the ball game so far. He's ready. Here's the 1-0. Now it's 2-0. Lifetime versus Joe Kelly. Just a 1 for 9. He's taken him deep once. And he'll lay the fastball in here to get the count back to 2-1.
Well, what's he looking for? 2-0 fastball right down the middle, and he took it? I don't know what he's thinking about. Maybe he thought he was going to throw him a breaking ball. I think you got to sit fastball there.
There's a high foul ball as it finds a lucky fan in the upper deck for a souvenir. And he'll stay alive here, but just barely as this ball's chopped foul at the plate, and the count holds at 2-2. The 2-2 one more time. Hit back up the middle. Bogarts has it. Throw on to first, gets him, and the side is retired. Down in order go the Rays, as they're unable to add to their 2-1 lead. Here's the left fielder, Hanley Ramirez. He's batting cleanup in this one, but will get us started here in the inning as they look to wake up the bats.
Yeah, not much to get excited about with just the single notch on the scoreboard, but you have to give credit to where it's deserved. The pitching on the other side has been really impressive.
Now a southpaw up to throw in that Tampa Bay bullpen. First pitch coming, here it is. Takes a high fastball for a strike.
He's really done a remarkable job considering the fact that he's thrown first pitch strike to less than half the guys in the lineup. He's under 50% right now, and that's usually not a recipe for success.
Favorable call in there for a strike. Now the 0-2 pitch. Chopped foul over towards the dugout. Ready with another 0-2. And a changeup swung on and missed for the first down.
The great equalizer, the changeup. That was a really good job of getting him to offer that one out of the zone. And it was all set up by the fact that he got ahead of the count and forced the hitter to have to protect. That's the name of the game.
Here's Jackie Bradley now. As he'll take a called strike here on a borderline pitch at strike one. 0 for 2 here to start the afternoon. Here's a curveball in the dirt that time for a ball. 1-1. On they'll run this one in on him, and he can't connect, so he finds himself down 1-2 now.
Oh, wow, that's what they call a jam sandwich. Wow, not much you can do with that pitch that's in tight.
1-2, here it comes. Swing and a miss on the changeup, and there are two gone.
Pitching 1-1 is changing location and upsetting the hitter's timing. You do that, and everything's going to be fine. In that strikeout, he never threw the same pitch twice in a row, and he won the battle because of it.
In now, Brock Holt. As he'll take one up in the zone, but indeed in the strike zone for the first strike. 0 for 2 for him to this point. Into the windup, here comes the 0-1. And this is lifted high in the air down the line behind third. And that will conclude matters here in the seventh. Down in order go the Red Sox. They're down 2-1. Ready once again, Michael King. He'll lead things off here in this one-run contest. Here's the pitch. And that one's in on the hands to start the inning. It's ball one. Pitch on the way. And that's off the plate and high. 2-0 now. From the windup, the 2-0 pitch. A changeup that just catches the bottom of the zone for a strike.
Probably better that he let that pitch go anyway. After seeing a lively fastball on the pitch before, it's pretty hard to sit back enough on a well-thrown changeup.
And that swung on and fouled straight back. All even at 2-2. Here it is. Just a bit low, ball three.
Walks are never good, but they're especially bad news late in games like this. It seems like they always come back to bite you.
Crowd gets up for the 3-2. Still hanging with him. Another good swing to keep it going. Heading out towards shallow right. On the move is Betts. He makes the catch. A great effort to get there and record the first out of the inning.
Mike Hilden. Steven Souza.
Digging in once again. Steven Souza. 0 for 2 with a walk for him so far. First pitch on its way. Swing and a miss just behind a lively fastball.
He may have to get his eyes checked on that one, because if he's looking for fastball, man, he had no chance of catching up to that. He better check his eyes. He was really late.
And this pitch is looked at for a ball, and that'll even the count to the Rays right fielder at 1-1. A 1-1 count. Here's the pitch. Swing, and that's hit out of play up into the plaza level. A ball and two strikes. Here's the pitch. Again, he sends it out of play.
That's probably not what he wants to do with two strikes right there with the fastball. He is fortunate he just fouled it off.
And he lays off a pitch outside as they draw even at 2-2.
Well, you talk about fighting. He's fouling balls off, fouling them off in a 1-2 count. He finally took a ball right there. I wonder if he feels more confident or he wants to keep swinging.
Drilled on the ground is short. In time to first, and there are two away.
Now batting, second baseman, Brad
Riding Miller. In once again, Brad Miller. Lifetime versus Joe Kelly. A number of meetings. He's 1-for-7. And the pitch. First pitch sinker misses in on the hands that time. It's a ball and no strikes. Into his windup. Here comes the 1-0. That one's going to find the seats. Strike one. Our pitcher's duel continues here. 2-1 score as we play the eighth. Fouled off again, and now he's in a 1-2 hole. Looking for the strikeout. Here's the 1-2. Frozen for strike three, and that retires the side. Rays go in order, 1-2-3. They lead it 2-1. Xavier Cedeño is on to pitch out of the bullpen in the bottom half of the eighth.
Xavier Cedeño.
Pablo Sandoval will be the first one to greet him, as he'll have to turn around and bat from the right side of the plate here.
Pablo Sandoval.
Curveball looked at here for strike one.
That's pretty good break right there, breaking all the way across the zone. Now, it's a little dangerous. He gets to see that ball a long time. But, man, that's a nasty snap, drag, and hook right there.
A good bend on that one as it's fouled away. Strike two.
Well, that's back-to-back breaking balls. He's able to foul that one off. Will they come back with a third?
Nothing in two count and the pitch. And now a curveball as he's got to lean out of the way. That one nearly got him. Here's the 1-2 delivery. Two balls and two strikes to the former World Series MVP.
Hey, one thing's clear. He's not afraid to pitch inside, right? One pitch ducks him away, then he comes right back with another one. So clearly this pitcher, he's not afraid to work that inner half of the plate.
Nasty breaking ball swung on in the dirt. Ramos gathers it, and the throw is there to record the first out.
You know, professional catchers make those plays look easy most of the time, but that was a big play that shouldn't go unnoticed. Had he found a way on, he would have represented a tying run, so that was a nice job there to make sure that strikeout didn't get wasted.
Here's Nick Castillo. We'll pinch hit here, and he's the potential tying run.
Number 42, Bruce Castillo.
Fastball in there for a called strike. Here's the pitch. Swing and a little blooper to center. Coming in is Rasmus. He gets there and makes a fine running play for the second out.
Now batting.
Chris Young will get the call to pinch hit here, as we'll see what he can do with two out and the bases empty. First pitch hack in here, and that's the first strike.
That ball's way out of the zone. He's got to set the side slower. You're looking fastball. I like that, but make him get the ball down. They'll never catch up to it up there.
Bases are empty here with two men out. And he just misses with a curveball.
Boy, that's a great breaking ball right there. That's a tough pitch to lay off when that ball is coming in at that plane right there. Quality take.
Here it comes on 1-1. And now a curveball that's low and in the dirt for a ball. It's 2-1. Grounded foul off to the left near Brian Butterfield in the third base coaching box. He's set. Here's the 2-2. They haven't played perfectly as it's hit on the ground. Gloved by Miller. And eight innings have come and gone now as the inning is over. Red Sox go down 1-2-3. They still trail it here 2-1. Young will stay in the ballgame now and take over in left field.
Now playing left field, number 42,
Tyler Thornburg enters from the pen to start the ninth inning as he'll try to keep the score right where it is heading to the bottom of the ninth. Blake Swihart is also into the ballgame as he'll likely go the rest of the way behind the plate. Stepping up now, Corey Dickerson. He'll be charged with trying to get on board leading off the ninth.
Corey Dickerson.
Here we go with inning number nine as the first pitch misses for ball one. The windup and the 1-0 pitch. There's a changeup over the outside corner.
Well, the first two pitches are interesting, both away from the left-hander. Will he bust him back in and challenge him? It's going to be a good at-bat to watch.
Ready to deal. Here's the 1-1. Line drive to left. But he'll hardly need to move out there in left as this is hauled in for the first out.
Now batting, third baseman, Evan Longoria.
In is the third baseman, Evan Longoria. He hit a sac fly earlier. And now the Red Sox will get a left-hander up and throwing in the bullpen. Ready to deliver. Here's the first pitch. And a curveball that started low and broke lower. Ball one. One out, nobody on. And that's in there for his strike, 1-1. From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. A wave and a miss, a tick behind a good fastball. Here he comes on a ball and two strikes. And they'll try to get him fishing there, but he won't offer in the dirt, and it's back to even at 2-2.
Well, that was a classic strikeout pitch with the changeup down right there. He just missed. You know, he hit fastball, fastball, then came back with the changeup. I think he comes back with another fastball in. You got him guessing now for sure.
And he struck him out.
Well, we've seen some really good pitching from these guys in this one. The bullpen has looked sharp and it backed up a nice effort turned in by the starter. These days, pitching has become a full staff effort, and I've been impressed with the job these guys have done so far.
First offering on its way. Wilson Ramos is at the plate as he looks at ball one. And a strike to even the count. 1-1. Here's the 1-1 pitch. Line to the right side. But he will close fast out there in right field as he comes on to put it away, and the inning is over. Down in order go the Rays. They still lead it 2-1. Alex Colome comes out of the bullpen to shut things down here in the ninth.
Number 42, Alex Colome.
There's the second baseman now, Dustin Pedroia. 0-for-2 on his line thus far.
Second baseman, Dustin Pedroia.
Close with the fastball to begin the at-bat. It's ball one. He's ready. Here's the 1-0. Runs outside, so it goes to 2-0 now.
Well, he's got himself in a good count right now. Down one, he's probably looking for something to drive out of the ballpark, maybe tie this game up.
Ready with the 2-0 pitch. Swinging a ball hit on the ground. But this will get foul, 2-1. Pedroia waiting on the 2-1. To third. Up with it is Longoria. Throws in time, and that's out number one.
Now batting, the shortstop.
Here's Xander Bogaerts now. He was retired via the ground ball last time up. Here's the first pitch to him. Checks his swing, but this pitch is right there for strike one.
That's a big pitch right there. It could change the at-bat. When you're facing a good hitter like this, that first pitch, strike one, is so important as to who's going to control this at-bat. Right now, pitcher's got the advantage.
Off the plate, one ball, one strike.
1-1.
And he'll miss the target there with the curveball, and it's 2-1 now. Set to deliver on 2-1. Lifted into center field. Rasmus has a read on it, and that's the second out of the inning.
Now batting, right fielder, Mookie.
Here's Mookie Betts. In the past against Alex Colome, have yielded just a 2-for-12. Into the windup and the pitch. The cutter runs outside, ball one. Into his windup, here comes the 1-0. And a fastball just a bit high.
2-0.
Here's the pitch. Hit down the third baseline, but a foul ball, and it's 2-1 now.
Well, he fouls off that fastball right there, and you wonder, does he love his fastball enough to come back with it three times in a row?
Sent fouled again, and after being way ahead, now it's even at 2-2.
Oh, he's going to want that pitch again. That ball's right down the middle in his wheelhouse. His eyes lit up. He just didn't let it travel deep enough where he could square it and keep it fair.
And the inning will continue as that's through for a two-out hit. So with two out, that means Hanley Ramirez will also get an opportunity here.
For the Red Sox, designated hitter, Hanley Ramirez.
Here's Hanley Ramirez, 0-for-3 with a couple of strikeouts for him to this point in the ballgame. And this is fouled back and out of play. Quick check on that tying run at first, and the runner back safely. Two out with the man at first. Pitch swung on and hit in the air. Souza on the move. Makes the catch, and that's the ball game.
Hey, a great win for these guys as they wrap up another one. But a little bit of a sour note, though. Everyone has to head home, get on those computers, and get those taxes out before midnight.
Pitching and defense game, 2-1, the final score this afternoon. The Rays win this one despite banging out only two hits. Alex Cobb takes the win on the mound, his second of the year, as he finishes seven innings, allowing only one hit.